Back in 1971, a movie called Johnny Got His Gun made waves. It's about a young soldier who gets stuck in a really tough situation after a bad accident. Imagine having no arms, no face, and no way to talk, just being stuck with your own thoughts. This film is a roller coaster of feelings. It has parts that make you laugh, shock you, and leave you feeling heavy-hearted. The soldier's journey makes you question a lot about being human. What keeps this movie timeless? Is it the exciting story, the strong acting, or maybe how it makes us think about the real cost of war? Tell us what you think makes this movie special. Now, here's a twist. Have you ever had a personal experience with Johnny Got His Gun that stuck with you? Maybe it influenced a big decision in your life or just made you think a lot. Share your stories in the comments. Funny, shocking, sad, this movie really hits hard and sticks with you. Share your stories and thoughts with us. We're listening. Johnny Got His Gun stands out as a powerful anti-war film, leaving a lasting impact on viewers. The narrative skillfully employs flashback elements, enhancing the appreciation of real-time events. In contrast to conventional Hollywood war films, this production distances itself from patriotic glorification, presenting the stark reality of war without the usual heroic clichés. Following its Cannes Festival preview, the audience's prolonged silence reflects the film's profound effect. Comparable films such as Fragments d'Antonin and La Chambre des Officiers touch on similar themes but remain more bearable despite their lack of explicit violence. The movie, devoid of visible blood, delves into the true horror of war, surpassing the impact of even the bloodiest horror or gore films. The central theme revolves around the protagonist's struggle with life and death, exploring the profound consequences of war on the human condition. The portrayal of Johnny as an ordinary man thrust into the machinery of war resonates with the film's overarching message. Dalton Trumbo's adaptation of the source material contributes to making it one of the most impactful book-to-film creations in cinematic history. The film serves as a poignant critique of those who romanticize war, presenting it as a horrifying experience that challenges one's perspective on life. Trumbo, known for his association with the Hollywood 10, is depicted not as a genius, but as a messenger with a gift for depicting harsh realities. The performances are deliberately normal, mirroring the average man caught in the machinations of war. In essence, Johnny Got His Gun provides a thought-provoking exploration of the true horrors of war, urging viewers to reconsider their stance on pacifism. The film's portrayal of the human condition, devoid of embellishments or heroic exaggerations, makes it an unparalleled examination of the devastating impact of armed conflict. After the movie's release, a tragic incident in California brought about significant changes in legislation. The key figure associated with the film, Donald Sutherland, met an unfortunate demise when he fell through a glass shower door, resulting in severe injuries and fatal bleeding. This incident led California to pass a state law requiring the use of safety glass in shower doors to prevent similar accidents. Donald's influence on the film industry extended to his family, notably his son Kiefer Sutherland, who played a role in Stand By Me, based on a Stephen King short story. Meanwhile, Donald appeared in Salem's Lot and featured in two film adaptations of Michael Crichton's works The Great Train Robbery and Disclosure. Another noteworthy connection is Ross of Sutherland, Donald's other son, who appeared in Timeline. A notable casting tidbit involves Dalton Trumbo's disappointment when Walter Matthau declined the role of Joe's father in the film. This casting decision played a crucial role in shaping the dynamics of Johnny Got His Gun. These behind-the-scenes details offer a glimpse into the interconnected web of personal and professional relationships in the film industry, showcasing how individual choices can ripple through generations. The repercussions of Donald Sutherland's tragic accident and the subsequent legislative response underscore the wide-reaching effects that extend beyond the confines of the cinematic world. In 1953, the lead actor in the 1971 film had his first taste of the limelight in the off-Broadway production of American Gothic, directed by Jose Quintero. Interestingly, Dalton Trumbo, the mastermind behind Johnny Got His Gun, once contemplated casting Steve Martin for the pivotal role of Joe Bonham, influenced by the fact that Martin was dating Trumbo's daughter during that period. Equally noteworthy is Trumbo's consideration of Anthony Quinn for the part eventually played by Jason Robards. These casting deliberations offer a glimpse into the process of bringing characters to life on the screen, revealing the director's careful considerations and the potential alternate paths the movie might have taken. The movie itself stands as a stark anti-war testament, departing from conventional Hollywood narratives by sidestepping patriotic glorification. Without explicit violence, it delves into the genuine horrors of war, depicting the struggles of an ordinary man caught in its relentless machinery. Trumbo's adaptation of the source material contributes to making it a poignant critique of those who romanticize war, presenting it as a harrowing experience that challenges one's perspective on life. Following its Cannes Festival preview, the film's profound impact is reflected in the audience's prolonged silence, distinguishing it from comparable films that touch on similar themes, but with a more bearable tone. The narrative, skillfully utilizing flashbacks, enhances the appreciation of real-time events, creating a lasting impression on viewers. Beyond the cinematic realm, the interconnected web of personal and professional relationships comes to light. Notably, Dalton Trumbo faced disappointment when Walter Matthau declined the role of Joe's father, a decision that significantly shaped the dynamics of the movie. The repercussions of these behind-the-scenes choices underline how individual decisions in the film industry can ripple through generations. In conclusion, the 1971 film, with its roots tracing back to the off-Broadway scene in 1953, continues to stand as a powerful anti-war narrative that transcends typical Hollywood war films. Its exploration of the human condition, devoid of embellishments or heroic exaggerations, makes it an unparalleled examination of the devastating impact of armed conflict on the individual. The intricacies of casting choices and behind-the-scenes dynamics further enrich the narrative, emphasizing the lasting relevance of this thought-provoking piece of cinema. In 1971, a film stood out for its powerful portrayal of the harsh realities of war. It avoided the typical patriotic themes found in Hollywood, presenting a raw narrative about a young soldier facing the aftermath of a devastating incident, left without limbs, face, or voice, only his own thoughts for company. This movie, known for its honest critique of war, cleverly used flashbacks to explore the profound effects of armed conflict on people. Instead of showing explicit violence, it focused on the genuine horrors of war through the eyes of an ordinary man trapped in its relentless machinery. Behind the scenes, the film industry's interconnected relationships played a crucial role. Dalton Trumbo, the mastermind behind the film, experienced disappointment when Walter Matthau turned down a vital role, influencing the movie's dynamics. These decisions had a lasting impact, emphasizing how individual choices shape the film industry over time. In 1953, the lead actor gained attention in an off-Broadway production, setting the stage for his role in this anti-war statement. Trumbo, the film's director, considered different casting options, offering a glimpse into the careful thought process behind the scenes and the potential alternate paths the movie could have taken. Beyond the world of cinema, a tragic incident involving Donald Sutherland, a key figure in the film, led to legislative changes. His influence extended to his family, particularly his son Kiefer Sutherland, who played a role in a Stephen King adaptation. The consequences of Donald Sutherland's accident highlight the wide-reaching effects that go beyond the boundaries of the cinematic world. In conclusion, the 1971 film remains a compelling exploration of the human condition amid the devastating effects of armed conflict. Its thought-provoking narrative, combined with the complexities of casting choices and behind-the-scenes dynamics, solidify its status as a timeless anti-war masterpiece.